Everybody, Sam'sTrains here. Welcome back to the railway and welcome to another live stream. It's lovely to have you all here, of course, and I hope you're looking forward to this as much as I am. So this episode, this week, is going to be all about you guys. I'm going to be running your requests. I'm going to be answering your questions, if you've got any, if you can think of any. I'm going to be showing your pictures. Anything along those lines is going to be what we're doing today. So I'm hoping you're all going to really, really enjoy it. So since this is your episode, that's what I'm going to call it, I'll start with the chat, as I always do. If anybody wants a shout out, pop in. I do have a shout out for KSuper1000 with three exclamation marks at the end of his name. Yep, he asked me for a shout out. So there you go. Hope you're watching. Haven't seen him there in the chat. So Sevy Babe says howdy, or words to that effect. There you go. Well, howdy to you too. Daniel Thomas is there. Adam Broomfield, hello. Adam Berry says well. Well, I'll add a few more wells to that. There we go. That's at least two. Biggie Nice 18 says hi. I like transport. Says hi, Sam. Franco RA says hello. Jack Clark, hello to you too. Angela Kogut is saying daylight. We always get some comments about the daylight. I wonder why. It's a very popular engine, that one. Hi, Richard Quinn, Ross Nation, hi, Piggy Nice 18, shout out please, there you go. Intercity 04, shout out, he says. Yeah, there you go, there's a shout out. Right, Toggy Saw says hi, Sam. his profile picture's tickled me very slightly. He looks like he's in a lot of pain. AZ Real, oh, thank you very much. He says, evening, Sam, looking forward to the stream. Well, me too, I can't wait to get started. It should be great. And Milo McQuillan, thank you very much to you too. He says, morning. Not heard any mooing so far. Is that on the way? I'm not going to start another sentence because I'm sure it will be. No, I think we got rid of it. Okay, fair enough. Are you sure? There we go. I knew it would be there. God, that was a delay, wasn't it? Crikey. You can never predict when they're coming. Right, well, let's carry on. How are we? Says Adam Berry. I'm very well, thank you. How are you, Adam? I hope you're doing good. SuperDude24 says, hi, Sam. Josh. Told you. I told you. That was Milo. There you go, Milo. You got your interruption. There you go. Dark Pitt's husband. Blimey, who's Dark Pitt? And you're her husband, I guess. I don't know. Lindsay Holmes, there you go. Scottish Rail Spotter. I saw earlier on some... there we go, Kathleen Ward. I'm using my grandma's computer for this. I saw that earlier on. That made me laugh. So Kathleen Ward's grandson / granddaughter is in the chat, being represented by Kathleen herself. So there we go. I'm sure she's not aware of this, but if she isn't, I guess you might be later on. If someone tells her. Mutant Fish, hi to you too. I love that name, Mutant Fish, that's brilliant. Stop being so moody, Borman. Yeah, I agree. Well, he's not being moody. I think that's his way of trying to say thank you, but every noise he makes comes out sounding the same. Sam Haslam, can I have a shout out? Serial donor at work, AZ Rail. Oh, I like the sound of that. Hello, Sam, Adrian, 111, cheers. Hello to you too. Chris McBride, hello. Can I get a shout out to SuperDude24? Blimey, there's a lot of people in this chat. I almost forgot to enable slow mode today. And yeah, it started to go crazy. But luckily, I think we're okay. So thank you all very much for popping in. I'm not saying goodbye. If you wanted a shout out and you didn't get one, stick around and I'll do some more later on. But I thought we'd better start off with some thank yous from last week, everybody that super chatted. So here we go. It was AZ Rail, Gareth Waite, Paul S, the Imperial Diamond Spinosaurus. Still love that name. The Ugly Duckman, Sparky 107107, Uni Kit Kat, Charles Curtis, Jason Biggs, Jake Darling, The Deem DD19, Milo McQuillan, and Jacob Wilson. So thank you all so much for your support last week. It really is very, very kind of you. Oh, and we have Deltic Dan 900. Blimey, it's been a while since I've heard of Deltic Dan. Brought a Hornby Livestream Mallard yesterday. Wow, that's amazing. I've always fancied one of those, but alas, they are pretty expensive, aren't they? Either way, all of those people that have donated are entered for the competition. Bullman and, well, not Bullman, Brazing. There we go. I always call him the wrong thing, but that is Brazing with a certificate, or the Hornby Shunter's truck if you fancied something a bit more serious. And everybody's welcome to enter today as well. The slate is wiped clean, you're able to enter. Oh, William Town, let's see. Can I have an open cab pannier with one Great Western four-wheel coach and one Great Western box wagon, a Great Western open wagon and a towed brake van, please? Yes, you very much can, William. Thank you so much for that. And of course, you two are now entered for this stuff if you're interested in that. And of course, if you want to enter as well, there is the super chat link in the, well, in the chat. Thank you so, so much in advance to anybody that decides to donate. It really is a massive support for the channel. It keeps things going. And of course, as you know, today's video slash stream is going to be all about requests and things. So if you have a request in mind, an engine that you'd like me to run, if you donate £5 or $5 or euros or anything like that or more, include your request in the super chat and I will do that for you, and you get your engine showed to the world. So there we go. And once again, a massive, massive thank you to everybody that decides to do that. It really is very kind of you. So speaking of that, I've got some set up and look, they're not in the normal place. I thought I would live dangerously and, well, almost crazily, in fact, and do things a bit different today. Paul S., oh, thank you so much. Can we see a standard class 5 double heading with a standard class 4 with coaches of your choice? Oh, I like that idea. Thank you very much, Paul. Thank you. So, where are the first engines, I hear you ask? Well, I don't. Maybe I see people asking in the chat. No, I don't think so. Right, they're there. Yes, living dangerously. Can you imagine that? Putting engines and things in different places. I know, it's crazy. Just try and hold it together if you can. Okay, so these are some of my engineers' requests that I collected during the week. So we have DLT Berkshire. He asked to see the Backman Pannier, and he was very specific that he wanted to see some beverage trucks behind there. So drinks, basically. So as you can see, there's all sorts here. We've got some 7-Up. Nope, know much about fizzy drinks because I don't really have them myself, but there's the 7-Up. We've got a couple of Pepsi, there's some Typhoo tea, we've got a Coca-Cola one here that I think you can just see, there's a tonic water, there's a couple of milks behind that which I think are probably out of shot. Yeah, they're out of shot, and there's a Toad, so you'll see that in just a second. Then on the middle line, a Loco that I haven't run as much as I wanted to because they're absolutely amazing, aren't they? But for some reason, I haven't run it much since I got it. So this was a request from Lakota Thiroff, who wanted to see the Atlantic, a Pullman coach, then a food wagon, so there's some peanuts. I think you can just about see the peanuts behind that first Pullman coach. Then another Pullman coach, in fact. Then another goods van. Then another Pullman, and then a brake. So I think people are trying to confuse me, aren't they, with these? But that's fair enough. And I mean, people, they get to choose what they like. So it's my job to try and do it. And then Michael Forster again, I think, was trying to challenge me here because he wanted to see two Bullet Pacifics double heading with a Q1 and lots of Southern coaches and Bullman and a Shunter's truck at the end. Now, unfortunately, I didn't really want to put three engines at the front of the train because it's going to take ages to put them on, ages to get them back off again while we're live. And also, it's more than likely to derail with so many engines, and it's not that great for the controller either. So I've just got one Bullet Pacific and one Q1. I'm hoping that's all right for you, Michael, but I have put on five coaches, and not just four, like I normally do. So hopefully you'll like that. And yes, I've been able to oblige the other parts of the request, and they're set in the wrong direction. I don't know how that happened. Okay, forwards then. I mean, I could run them backwards, but I think they'd just derail, wouldn't they? So better not do that. So there we go, that was for Michael. We have the Lakota Theory. Oh, that's set the wrong way as well. What's going on? I reckon someone must have been up here to sabotage this, because I'm sure I didn't do this. Okay, the H1 from Lakota Thiroff, there we go. And very finally then, we have the not only the Backman Pannier tank, let's bring this back so you can see it. Oh, that was set the wrong way as well. Oh, blimey, how embarrassing. There you go, can you see that better? It is the Backman Pannier tank in the Railway Children. I think it's G, N and S, R or something like that, which stands for the Great North and South Railway. Thank you so much, whoever that was. Let me run and see if I can find out. It was Javen A. Bird, and I just missed it. Oh, thank you very much, Javen. Thank you for that. I don't think he left a message, so yeah, that's why I wasn't able to read it in time. Cheers, Javen, says Mark. Super Tomski 53 says, can I get a shout out? Yes, you can, of course. There it is for you there. Let's take a look. Bullman spotted, says Mark. Oh, was Bullman spotted? I'm not going to say anything else. An E2 going in reverse, says Lost Dreams. That's not a bad idea. I like that idea, although I bet the engines don't like that idea. I think it frightens them having to go backwards. Bill Powers, happy spring. That is true. This is the first live stream in spring. And it has been quite nice, oddly. It's been nice weather for a little while, so maybe we could even call it spring. Oh, the Ugly Duckman, thank you so much. Oh, for me and Mark, let's get the N-Class on a mixed train, please. Oh, well, thank you so much, Ugly Duckman, for that. And yes, I certainly will do the end class for you. And blimey, we got my terrifying, creepy face on there. So that's all good, isn't it, that? Now, I've just heard some dodgy sounds coming from behind the bookcase there. Can you take a close look at those Pullmans? I swear I heard one of them come off the track. No. I don't know, it doesn't sound right. I'm going to follow it with the cameras just in case. I think there's something wrong there. Lionel Lego King 2006 says, shout out please. Well, there you go. Yes, I know, Franco. Definitely great requests, especially the beverage one. Yeah, where is that beverage train? Let's have a look, shall we? There it goes. It's just disappearing. I thought I had more beverage wagons than that. I was going to do a massive train full, but no, I mean, that's not too bad, is it? That's quite a few. At the watercress line for my dad for his 74th birthday, says James Stewart. Wow, fantastic. Well, wish your dad a very happy birthday from me, please. And I hope you're having a fantastic day. And of course, thank you so, so much for the donation. That's very, very good of you. Aww. And there we go. There's your pop-up. Forever on the stream. There you go. Did I miss anything? Not too much, MBC Machatu. No, we've just started really with these requests, which are quite cool. We've got a beverage train just there. What else? Just trying to figure out. So there's the beverage train. Ta-da. With the Backman Pannier. There we have a West Country class with a Q1, some Southern coaches, and a Shunter's truck. And where's the other one? Should be another one someplace. Oh, it's just disappeared behind the bookcase. There it is. Oh, no. No, that's the... I don't know where the other one's gone. I'm confused. Oh, odd. Oh, well, there's another one anyway. It is an Atlantic with some various coaches and things. Ah, here it is. I don't know. It's difficult trying to edit these things when you lose track of an engine. Anyway, that's cool as well, isn't it? Don't you think? Wow, says Scottish Train Spotter. Yeah, I mean, this is taking unusual requests to an all new level. So I set that as a challenge. If anyone's thinking of setting a request, see if you can go unusual. I mean, you don't have to, it's your request, but if you fancy doing something dangerously odd, I'll be willing to try. So there we go. A lot of brown locos, I've noticed. I don't know whether that's a coincidence. I suppose it must be. But we've got the pannier that's brown and the H1 that's brown. That's quite cool. Just waiting for the other two. Where are they? Let's see if I can change shot. See if we can get another look at those running by with the bullied train. I do love the bullied stuff. That's great, isn't it? Matt O'Vell says dizzy. I hope you're not too dizzy. Where's Bullman, says Steam Fanatic. Well, Bullman comes and goes as he pleases. There's certainly no way to stop him. So there we go. All right, well, thank you very, very much, guys, for those requests. I love those. We've got some more to do later on, so if you've still got a request in mind, there's going to be loads and loads of time. I'm going to be making time, in fact, to do those today. So, yes, you should be able to get in if you want to. And, again, thank you in advance for that. All right. So, I wanted to have some fun today. You know, I don't want things to get too dull and boring, so I thought I would pick three of my most exciting new purchases and show them to you before I review them. I think all of them, in fact, is the first time I've ever shown them on the channel. So these are three models that I'm quite excited. I've never shown them before, and I thought I would just give you a tiny little sneak preview. I'm not going to be getting them out or anything on the stream, but I thought I would just show them to you and see what you think. So the first piece is a bit of rolling stock, and this is made by Oxford Rail, who made the N7. And of course, after the N7, I was thinking, you know, what else has Oxford got to offer? Because that was so good. So I decided to buy this. I bought it from Hattons, and I'm going to review this quite soon over the next few weeks. It is, I'll read you exactly what it is. It's a BR Toad four-wheel, and it's Barla. There we go. I just thought, these are so inexpensive, and they are, by the way, £12.50 I think this cost me. I thought, you know what, I'm going to buy one of these, and I'm going to do a mini unboxing on it and see what it's like. So I'm really looking forward to that. It looks superb. I mean, obviously, because it's got a see-through box, you can't help but just have a bit of a look at it. And in fact, I'll let you do the same. Let's try this. Oh, you've got the mug up close. Let's move the mug, shall I? There we go. I don't want to show it too close because that would spoil the review. And you can sort of see me. Hello. There you go. So yeah, I really like that. And I thought for £12.50, I thought I was going to pick that up. So let's have a look. Let's see what people think about that one then. I mean, is that exciting or not? Maybe I'm a bit sad for getting excited over that. Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Steam Fanatic says Toad. I know a lot of people like Toads, so I suppose that's the thing. But it's quite a short-looking toad. I didn't realise there were so many different types of toad, but I think there are. I've got several, and I didn't even know. I just thought, you know, one of them's an old model, so I thought perhaps they got it wrong. But no, apparently there are lots of different types of toad, and that's one of the shorter ones. Diamond 7/8 Forces, that looks cool. I think it looks cool. It's quite a nice grey livery. Puppy Dog Tails. What's the matter, Mark? Have I missed something? It's a good variant. Okay, good, good. Looks very nice, Austin Byrne. Anyone know when it came out, by the way? Because it looks very modern, but I can't remember when they came out. But it looks modern, as I say. I'm jealous. I love it, and I'm jealous of you, says ScottRail158707. Oh, well, don't be jealous. Don't be jealous. It might not be any good. I'm sure it will be, but I don't know yet. Everyone likes toads, says William Town. Yeah, I agree. I think everyone does. You're not alone getting excited, says Castle Junction. All right, okay. Well, if we're talking of excitement, shall I show you a loco then? Again, I don't think I've shown this before. So, it's not very revealing because it's in white paper. Maybe I have shown this before. Anyway, I haven't reviewed it yet, obviously. It's still wrapped in paper. So, if I just slide it out, let me know. Have I showed this before? There we go. It's a Stania Mogul. Danny Scott, thank you so much. He says, loved your reviews of the pre-grouping models and liveries, especially the S&CR. Sorry, S-E-N-C-R. Shout out to... Who was that? Shout out to Spartacus. He is not well at the moment. Q1s are awesome. All right, well, Spartacus, I'm sorry to hear that you're not doing too well. I hope you're feeling better soon. And yeah, all of my best wishes to you, and I'm sure everyone else in the stream will say the same. Get well soon. Hope it's all right for you. Anyway, so yeah, this, it's let's get it out again, shall we? Stania Mogul. I'm looking forward to doing this. As I say, though, it weighs an absolute ton. I've only just noticed that. I've had this for a couple of months, and I've never had it out, but I never realised just how heavy it was. So maybe we're in for a real surprise with that one. So, yep, that's a Backman one, of course. You probably might not be able to tell because the box is all covered up. But yeah, Stania Mogul. I've always fancied one, and I picked one up not too long ago. So what do you reckon to that? The frog van, I saw someone put. Oh, Paul S, thank you very, very much for becoming a member. I hope you like it. In fact, we had the members live stream last week, so if you want to check that out, you should still have access to it. Ooh la la, says Thomas Palmer. Thank you, glad you like that. SuperDude24, oh, thank you so much. He says, your videos are awesome, Sam, and so are you. Oh, I don't know about that, but thank you very much. It's nice to read that, thank you. What about the race for America versus the UK? Do you mean in general? Are the countries against each other? Paul S, there we go. Or do you mean engines? I don't know. I could do some races between UK and American stuff. Let me know in the chat if that's something you'd like to see. Maybe I could try it. SuperDude24, no problem. Backman LMS, Stania Mogul, with a big grin face, says Jordan. There you go. Yes, I'm quite excited about that. I don't think I've ever seen one in the flesh. I've seen pictures of them, obviously, but I've never seen one. So whenever, I'm going to try not to look at any. I bet people are going to start sending me them now, aren't they? But I'm going to try not to see one until my review, so it'll be a complete surprise. Do you have a big boy Union Pacific, says Diamond 784. Now, this has to be the question that I get asked about 10 times a week, honestly. It's a good question, too. I don't have one, sadly. I wish I did, but they are rather expensive, and I'm not 100% sure one would work on my track. But apart from that, yeah, I would love one. Gareth Waite, wow, thank you so much for that. He says, hi, Sam. I've just done the London exhibition and met the guys again from Hatton's and grabbed some bargains. Could you run the Mallard with your choice of wagons? Thank you once again, Gareth Waite, and yes, I can certainly do that. Thank you very much once again. And with that then, has anybody else been in London for the London Festival of what is it now? Railway modelling, I think it is. It's been quite a good show. I've been looking at some of the different pictures and things from there, and so if anybody's been there, or maybe, I don't know, you might be in the car on the way back, let me know. How was it? I know Mark was there. And I'm sure Mark won't mind me saying, but he bought an N-Class. He's been after an N-Class for absolutely ages, and apparently he got one in London just today, or maybe yesterday. So let us know, Mark, if you're willing to. Let us know the details, what livery is it in. I assume it's a Southern one, but you never know. I think Backman have done some BR versions. Oh, we saw the two Daves at Ali Pali. Oh, I hope you said hello for me. I hope they're doing all right. It's too far for me to go, says Castle Junction. Yeah, it was a little bit far for me as well. But either way, I suppose it would have been worth the trip. But yeah, I'm not very good with travelling, to be honest. A bit too lazy, I guess. Adam Rushton. I sort of merged your two names together there. I called you Rudden. Maybe that's a new nickname that will catch on. But yeah, I'm all right, thank you. Apart from getting tongue-tied, I'm not too bad. Hertz Train Spotting says he got one. Oh, that's good. You got one too. And hello from Brazil, says Anthony Bortiz, I guess. Well, hello to you too. I can't remember ever having a comment from Brazil before. That's very cool. Oh, Charles Curtis. Wow, thank you so much. Wow, that's very generous. Thank you, Charles. He says, thank you for the live stream. Well, no, thank you. Thank you for joining and watching. Right. Okay, one more surprise then. One more exciting purchase. And I'm not really going to show you very much about this one, apart from just the outside of the box. So it is Spectrum. It's made by Backman, and I think Spectrum, if I've got this right, is their sort of high-level stuff, the top-of-the-range stuff in America and that sort of thing. Now, there's a bit of a story with this. One of my friends slash viewers called Jonathan said he's selling one of these. He doesn't want it anymore. I didn't really pry as to why he was selling it. But he doesn't want it anymore, and he says he's not too bothered about what he gets for it as long as it goes to a good home. So I was talking to him about it, and he said he only wants 30 quid for it. So I thought, blimey, all right. Well, okay, I'll give you 30 quid for it. And so he sent it. He's not from around here. He's not from the UK. I think he's... I might say the wrong thing here, but I think it was Sweden maybe, or something like that, Denmark, something like that. Not from around here, somewhere else in Europe anyway. And he was very good to let me have it so inexpensively. So that has been a really exciting one. I'll read you what it says on the end. It's number 81709. It's an HO, because that's normally the case with European and American stuff. It's a 210O, so a little bit like the 9F. It's a Russian decapod from the AT and SF, so I'm really looking forward to getting this one out. Apparently, as I say, the Spectrum stuff is the top of the range Backman stuff, so I really can't wait to get that out. So yeah, if anybody's got one, I suppose you can spoil it for me. Let me know what these are like, and yes, soon I will unbox this and we'll find out together. So there we go, that's just a few of my recent purchases that I'm a bit excited about, and I thought I would show them to you. Oh, I wish I could go to England again, says It's Meat Taco Studios 11123. Well, it is quite nice over here, but you have to come at the right time, otherwise you might get wet, put it that way. Poor Pear Marquette. Why, Jason, what's wrong with old Pear Marquette? Hi Sam, I'm from Illinois, USA. Well, that's very cool. Thank you for joining from all the way over there. That's pretty cool. What time is it over there? It might be early. Old Maud, lovely, says Duckman. Cool. Looking forward to that review, says Castle Junction. Yeah, me too. I can't wait to see what that's like. I may have had it out to service it, which makes me sound like I'm not being honest when I say I can't wait to see what it's like. But it's this difficult situation where you get it out of the packaging like this, try not to look. You put one of those foam thingies around it, let me show you. One of those cradles, which hides all the bodywork, so you can't see what you're dealing with. And I just took the mechanism apart. It's belt-driven, by the way. It's actually belt-driven, which fills me with a bit of trepidation, of course. But no, it did seem to work all right after a bit of oil, although, of course, you don't want any oil on the belt drive. So yeah, it should be interesting, that, to say the very least. Hello from Northern Ireland, says Fergus fan number one. Well, hello to you too. Nice to hear from Northern Ireland. Hope things are going well over there for you. And yes, Adam, yeah, I'm looking forward to that as well. Warlord, shout out, please. Hertz Train Spotting says he got a Class 92 for £28. That sounds all right, doesn't it? What brand was that? At the iForm. Not sure what that is, but that sounds good. Sounds very good. Oh, right. Duckman, actually, he doesn't. Oh, I must have encroached on a conversation there. And Adam Berry is back. Well, welcome back, Adam. Hope you're doing all right. Okay, so let's do... All right, shall we show some Wall of Fame stuff? Now, loads and loads of people have sent stuff into the Wall of Fame. I think I probably talked about it quite a lot last week, and it's caused a lot of people to send photos in. But there's the Wall of Fame. You can see it just behind me there. It really is filling up. In fact, what I've started to do is add some on this end. Can I point? That way. That end there, so it's going to start going across this end of the wall, which I think will make it better for live streams. But of course, there's like a storage door just behind there. And the thing is, your head and other body parts seem to brush against the ceiling when you go in and out of there, which is why I haven't put stuff there for the time being. But to be honest, we're running out of wall. If I panned this way, you would see they go right across the wall. So there's no choice in that. But either way, if you want to send something in, my email address is in the description. You can send it there and I will put it up. But as I say, I had quite a lot over the last week. So what I've done is I've filled up today's quota and I've saved saved a few, and I'm going to carry those over to next week. So if you've sent something and it isn't here today, don't worry, I haven't deleted it or forgotten it or anything like that. It's going to be coming. Just hang on and I'll show it next time. So this one confused me. I don't know what's going on here. Infinity W. So we have some sort of southern locomotive. It looks like a Mahano if I had to guess, but I'm not absolutely sure. And it's hauling what looks like a gigantic rusty nail on a low loader. Now, Infinity W, if you're watching, is it a giant rusty nail? I don't think there was any explanation with the email. So it could just be a rusty nail, or it looks like some sort of chocolate maybe, like a pipe or something. I don't know, but either way, and there's a biscuit tin. There's a biscuit tin in the background. So maybe it's some sort of delicacy, I don't know. But either way, it looks like a rusty nail, so I thought that was quite entertaining. Now this is very, very impressive. I'm not absolutely sure which engine it is, but it's by James P, and it's a fantastic drawing. So what I've decided to do is, for any drawings, I'm going to actually show a close-up. Oh, that mug's in the way again. Come out the way, Bullman mug. There we go. So this way, you can at least appreciate the drawings. I love the cylinders there, by the way. They're pretty well drawn. In fact, it's all very well drawn. Look at that. So I love the sort of the impression of depth that it gives, shall I say. It looks really, really cool. I love the way the coaches disappear into the background, and you've got this artistic interpretation of a scenic backdrop with a beautiful dead tree in the background. So I really like that. Looks like some sort of Great Western 460 of some description, maybe a castle or a king, but it looks good to me. So thank you very much for that, James. You are a much more skilled artist than I am. 607 something maybe, so look up that number, somebody, and let me know what it was. But yeah, that's very, very good. Now we have a bit of photography from Yazza B, some sort of steam loco on a massive viaduct, as you can see. Not absolutely sure where this is, but the thing that strikes me is that there's so many coaches on that train. In fact, let's go with another close-up. Look at that. That must be, I don't know, I mean, I suppose in model form that wouldn't seem like such a lot of coaches, but in real life that must stretch back such a long way. It's quite a high viaduct. So yeah, I like that. Thank you, Yazza, for that, or Yazza, I don't know exactly how you pronounce it. People ought to let me know in the emails, how do you pronounce the names, because I'm sick of embarrassing myself like this. But that's okay, I try. Okay, so SG Kingley sent me loads and loads of pictures of a model aircraft that he was building. I don't even know if he intended them to go up on the wall, to be honest, but I thought, you know what, I'm going to show it anyway. So this is the one that was particularly impressive to me. It is a shot of a partially deconstructed aeroplane, but the thing that was impressive about this was the cockpit, because he's managed to fully detail a cockpit. Look at that. So I thought that was quite impressive. There were other photos. I ought to have shown them, really, because they showed just how tiny this thing was. I mean, you can see from the print on whatever page that is, you can see how tiny it is. But I thought, you know, it's not a train. That's true. Although I suppose it could be. It looks like some sort of diesel cockpit without the wings or anything. But either way, you know, the level of detail on that, I think, is worth a mention, isn't it? So thank you for that, SG Kingley. I'll definitely get that up. Mysterious G sent in this. It looks like, would that be a Class 60? I'm not too sure on my electrics and diesels and things, but either way, it's a beautiful photograph. I'm sure you'll agree, very nicely photographed here. And here is a very topical and also very, very beautiful drawing by Owen K, who drew a terrier. Now, just, you probably can't get a sense of how good this drawing is, but again, very, very nicely drawn. Not sure how old Owen is. Let's see if I can make out what it says. There is some text at the top. If anyone can make that out, let me know. But it says LBSC Terrier number 83, Earlswood. Absolutely lovely. So thank you for that, Owen. That is really, really good. I love it when people draw stuff. That's very, very cool. And by the way, if you do want to send a drawing and have, you know, its very own moment on the stream, if you've drawn something you're proud of, you can actually send it to me, to my PO box. I pointed the wrong way again. It's there. There we go. I have had a couple of things already that I'm collecting, but not an awful lot. So if you want a special mention on the stream, you can send a letter or a drawing to the PO box and I will show it in the final episode. So keep sending them, and I can't wait to open all the letters and things on the last stream. So that will be awesome. Anyway, here's one from Ronan. I'm sure this is a model, but oh, blimey. Marcus McDonald. Wow, Marcus, thank you so much. Right, I'm going to read it on here because it disappears too soon. Hi, Sam, as a request, could you run a standard 4 260 and a 9F double heading in black, preferably, okay, with the forefront Eh? With the four in front? Oh, okay. On 8 green coaches and a parcels van. Thanks, man. Great stuff. Awesome videos. Well, thank you so much again, Marcus. That's very, very kind of you. And yes, I can certainly do that for you. And William Town as well. Have you played Metro Exodus? There is a massive steam locomotive called Aurora in it. No, I'm more of a steam fan in terms of the platform, so I haven't touched that. But if it's good, I might try it one day. And SuperDude24 is a new member. Thank you so much. Is it welcome back or welcome for the first time? I think it's welcome for the first time. Either way, welcome and thank you so much, everybody, for your generous super chats. Okay, so Ronan J, either way, not absolutely sure. Let's see if we can get a vote, shall we? Are we saying real or model? I think model, but it's very, very difficult to say. And thank you again, Super Dude. Thank you, thank you. Yeah, I mean, just that. I think it's the road that does it. The road is super, super good looking. So I reckon it's a model, but only just. Very, very good that. Okay, so now this is awesome. I don't really. So it says, I'll show you in a second. It says Lines West Railway, pass of Bullman of Sam'sTrains to ride free until October the 31st, 2020, from Brent Arrett, company president. Just look at that. So it's like a little certificate. And this is a new one. Jake Darling, thank you very, very much. Only just remembered this was on, so not sure what's been run. But could you run a Britannia with a 47 banking? Yes, very, very good idea. And thank you very much once again for the generosity, Jake. You and everybody else that's already donated is entered to win Bullman and the Shunter's truck, of course. And there's only a couple of weeks left now before I do the draw, so keep them coming. And once again, thank you so much for the support. So there you go. I thought that was worth a mention. Very, very nicely made is that. I love the way the text goes around the smoke of the engine. That's very, very good. So thank you, Brent, for that. I don't know whether it's a genuine, it might, I suppose, be a genuine voucher, but I've dropped it. But I don't know if I'll ever get down there. But either way, thank you very much for that. Is the Lines West Railway real? I don't know. It might be a model railway. Well, for all I know, I'm not 100% sure. Okay, so we have Bullet Pacific fan with what looks like Golden Arrow there. So that is definitely an engine after my own heart. I do love the Bullet Pacifics there. Now, I did say I wanted some tiny square ones. So Brannan B, don't be upset that I've printed this off as a tiny square, because it will actually fit perfectly into a space on the Wall of Fame that's been bugging me for some time. So yes, that is going to be a big relief to get that up, put it that way. So thank you very much, Brannan, for that one. JJ Surtees has sent this in. It looks like an SECR H-class maybe, with a C-class or something behind it. It looks absolutely gorgeous though, so that is lovely. I love seeing these pre-grouping engines, so thank you for that one. I'm going to enjoy, I'm going to have to put that somewhere where I'll see it every time I come up the loft, and then I'll be able to enjoy it every time. Leon has sent in this. It looks like an HST125. Once again, beautiful artistic interpretation. It looks like it's in motion. It's almost got some motion blur on there, or I don't know whether that's just the camera that snapped it. But either way, I think we've got a budding young railway artist or painter or something like that in the works there. So that's very, very good. Well done, Leon. Thank you for that. And that's a good handy shape. I've got some long thin spots on the Wall of Fame, so that's going to be just perfect. Martin M sent in this. Goodness knows what's happening here. James is having a ride in a wagon. Let's see if I can show this up close. I don't know whether James has broken down or whether he's doing this for leisure or what, but either way, I can't imagine he'd enjoy that too much. He's sort of propped up on Donald's tender and another sort of goods van. It's almost like James has become a sort of goods thing to be shipped. I don't know. Either way, I don't know. Maybe he's enjoying it, but I can't imagine he'd like that particularly. So either way, I hope your James is okay, Martin. Let me know what the situation was with that. I can't remember whether he said in his email or not, but maybe he did. Okay, so Callum B sent in this one. Mayflower, is this a B1 or a B17 or something? It looks like that anyway. Certainly XLNER, it looks like. So thank you for that one. That's very, very lovely. I do love these Doncaster green engines. Clanline 35028 sent in this. A couple of what look like perhaps narrow gauge engines. Yeah, I'm going to say that. I'm going to say narrow gauge. They certainly do look it. So that's a beautifully taken photo from Train Simulator, it looks like. But no, thank you for that. That's great. There's also an odd-looking bloke on the right-hand side who seems to be photobombing. Very, very confidently in a way. He's standing with his shoulders all square and such. So that's I quite enjoyed that. I thought about cropping him out, but I thought no, he went to all the effort of being in the photo, so we'll keep him in. And then Jerome sent this one. I think this is from the Netherlands, if that's right. I might have misremembered that. But either way, it's some sort of diesel shunter from the Netherlands, and I thought that was really, really cool. So thank you, Jerome, for sending that in. And of course, I'll be doing this every week, so if you want to send something in for the Wall of Fame before it's completely full, then feel free to do that, and that should be pretty cool. Castle Junction says it was indeed a B1, so there you go, that's what it was. Oh, the Mayflower, says Scottish Train Spotter. Yes, the Mayflower. Oh, it is a B1. Everyone's saying B1, so that's good. Yes, it must be that then. All right, very cool. So we've got a lot of requests to do, I think, haven't we? So I'm going to set some of those up. I'm going to go for a little break. After the break, I'm going to do a bit of a Q&A. So if you want to think of some questions, they don't have to be railway related. They can be about anything. They can be about me. They can be about railways, although I don't know a lot about railways. So yes, I might not know the answers. But either way, do let me know. Do think of some questions, and we'll have those in just a second. Otherwise, then, I'll be right back in just a few minutes. I'm going to set up the next three requests, and I can't wait to see what they're like. So I'll be back in just a second. Don't go anywhere, folks, and I'll see you very, very soon. Hey folks, I've decided that I'm just taking too long doing this, so I thought I might as well show you what I'm doing rather than just make you sit and listen to that frankly god-awful music. So I've already set up the standard class 5 and the standard class 4, which I think was for Paul. I've had to put the 5 at the front though, because that was the only one that had because the 4 at the back was the only one that had the front coupling, so I had to do it that way. And then I've had a slight panic with Rodney and the Duchess of Rutland, because Rodney was running super, super slow to start with. I don't know why, maybe he's due for a service, I'm not sure, but Rutland was having to force him forwards really, really abruptly, and I thought, man, she's going to burn out. But it seems as though, after a little bit of forwards and backwards running, old Rodney seems to have loosened up a little bit, which is good. So all that's left now is to do William Towns, which was the open-roofed pannier, a four-wheeled Great Western coach, which I think I might struggle with, just thinking about that. I think I know which ones he might be thinking of, but I don't think I have. Yeah, either my mind has just failed me completely, or I think I don't have any Great Western four-wheeled coaches. So it might have to be one of my smaller eight-wheeled wagons, coaches, whatever you want to call them, I think. Yeah, I don't think I do have. I'm sorry about that. Yeah, I don't reckon I do. I was a bit confused then, because I seem to remember something about a Great Western four-wheeled coach. But no, I don't think I do. So I'll put one of these on. You'll have to let me know, William, whether this is what you had in mind or whether I'm just being stupid and I've forgotten that I do actually have the right thing. But if I can get these to couple, come on. I think it's off. Yeah, it's not on right. See, this is why I decided to come back and show you this, because it ain't going to be done quick. There we are, just worked that time. Okay, so that's the coach. So we wanted to see a Great Western box van and an open Great Western wagon. Ooh, okay. Blimey, this one's a bit of a challenge. Okay, so amazingly, I've just opened the drawer and found the Great Western box van straight away. So I'll pop that on. That's new, isn't it? That's the one from last week, the one that I unboxed from the train pack. So I think that will be its first ever run, won't it? So that's pretty cool. I'm going to struggle to find a Great Western open van. So what I might do is do something naughty and just put on a generic looking one to save some time, and also a Toad. But I think we've got a Toad somewhere, haven't we? I've just taken one off, so that's okay. I'll try that. Yes, also from last week, I believe. So there we go, there's your little ocean open wagon. Not an ocean wagon, we've got some of those coming next. And then the Toad on the back, there we go. So we'll get those running in just a second, but I did promise a Q&A, so we'll get on to that. And so if anybody's got questions, feel free to send them now, and I will take a look and see what people are saying. Snow, says Mr. Steal Your Bread. Blimey, have you got snow? To be honest, I haven't got a window up here, so yeah, it could be snowing, but I won't know about it, unfortunately. Yeet Station 4, says Pacific CY. Don't know what that means, but a lot of people are saying it, so I missed something. I must have missed something in this chat, because something odd is going on. Anyway, what's your favourite weather? Oh, I see. Okay. I guess I like most weathers, to be honest. Luckily, my hobby doesn't depend on the weather, so it doesn't matter too much. I like snow, but I also like fair weather as well. I like, if it's warm enough not to have to wear a coat or a jumper, then it's all right to me. I think that's all right. Have you got much planned this summer? MDH Games. Ask Samantha. I'm going to ignore that. Not an awful lot. I am planning to do a few more railways. I'm not going to say which ones yet in case I don't manage it and people are disappointed. But yeah, I'm hoping to go to a few. Colin Wikes. Am I saying it right? Is it Wakes? Wikes? Thank you so much for that though, Colin. I really do appreciate that. Blimey, people are being crazy generous today. Thank you, Colin. I really appreciate that. Okay, let's get back. Do you have any Marklin, Lima or Fratesi rolling stock, or have you ever heard of these brands? Yes, I've heard them. Right, let's see. Marklin, yes, I have a little bit of rolling stock from Marklin, but it's three rail, so it doesn't work. Lima, yes, I've got plenty of Lima. Fratesi, no, but I've serviced one before. So yes, I've heard of them all, but I can't tell you an awful lot about them. What is your favourite review you have done? Definitely the Tart Class for April Fools. I think that was my favourite. How are you, mate? Well, that's a question. So I'm fine, thank you. I hope you're okay too. You are thinking of going down to Dartmouth this year. Thinking about it. Can't say for sure yet, but yeah, I would love to go back to the SDR again, the South Devon Railway. I do love it down there. Blimey. William Town again. I was talking about a Hornby four-wheeled coach in a Great Western livery. Right, okay, yeah, sadly I don't think I do. I do have quite a lot of those Hornby four-wheelers, but not in Great Western, I don't think. So if I see you in the chat, I'll give you the choice. You can change for a non-Great Western four-wheeled wagon, but either way, it's up to you. It's up to you. Okay. I think all the BR diesels look terrible, and bright yellow kills it for me. And their horns are bad too, says Mickintendo 2003. Oof, that's a very, very controversial point of view. And Steam Traction Spotter, blimey, this is very generous of you. Thank you very much. What do you prefer, Southern Region or Western Region? Oh, this is going to get me into trouble, isn't it? I think for me, it's Southern Region. I think people will probably get cross if they're Great Western fans. But yeah, I think for me, it's got to be like that. Have you ever heard of Pioneer Zipier? I don't think so. What is that? Do enlighten me. Tart, says Dab on Clickbait. Good old Tart class. What is your absolute favourite steam engine class? Still the Battle of Britain, I think. Who asked that? Mike Nintendo 2003. There we go. Who's your favourite Sam'sTrains? Says Arleydale Engine 90. I think Gordon. Still got to be Gordon or Toby. I've been more fond of Toby recently. Giacomus Prime says bye. Well, bye. Hope you enjoyed what you saw. Thank you very much for coming. Hi, says K Supper, or Super, I guess, 1000. I did give you a shout out earlier on. I don't know if you saw it. And Ethan's Train says Sam. I think that's because I got his name wrong earlier. I called him Ethan. And I thought he told me his name was Ethan, but no, apparently it is Ethan. I don't know. Toby Cohen, when will you be showing our Insta posts? I will be showing the Instagram posts later on. So I tell you what, shall we get onto the requests? And the sooner we get some of those done, we will get onto Instagram. So here they are. You have just seen them, so it's not the big reveal I hoped it would be. Either way, so on the outside line, you can see we have Jack C's request. Request? Blimey. I'll tell you what, I am losing my my tongue, aren't I? A request, that's it. So that's from Jack C. It's the Duchess of Rutland with Rodney and the Intercity coaches. So if I can, we'll try and get that started. If it looks like Duchess of Rutland is struggling to pull old Rodney along, because Rodney is an old grumpy engine, so we'll have to see. But if it looks like she's struggling, we might have to bring those to a stop a little bit sooner. But hopefully, fingers crossed, it'll be okay. William Town wants to see the Pannier with the open cab, which is the 2721 class, I think. I think I have got the wrong coach, unfortunately. I'm sorry about that, William. I'll owe you a favour for that one. I do apologise. And then Paul S's idea to have the Standard 5 and the Standard 4 together. So I'm hoping this is all right for you. The coaches of your choice, so I kept the Southern ones. Oh, and there's a naughty Great Western Shunters truck on the end there as well. It's a little bit of advertising for the competition there, isn't it? So thank you for those folks, and whoever that was TrainDude456. Thank you very much for that, TrainDude456. He says, can you do a double header with the Black 5 and a Hornby Henry? That's not a bad idea. Yes, I can certainly do that. Thank you very much for that. And yes, I'll get to that. I have got quite a lot of requests now for today, so whether or not I get through them all, I'm not 100% sure. But I'll certainly try to. And it looks like the Standard train is struggling a bit, doesn't it? Or are they just going slowly? I'm not 100% sure. Well, shall we follow them round and take a look? We'll go behind the bookcase and see. Yeah, they just seem to be going quite fast, and it looked like the wheels on the engine at the front, I forget which one it was now, it looked like they were going round quite fast. So if we're going to have a burnout, at least it's going to be on camera. That's the most positive way of looking at it, I think. Let's have a quick look. Oh no, I think we're okay. I think they're just slow runners. I think that's all, which is okay. It's not too bad. Philip Page, how about a tender driven only running session? Oh, that'd be cool. I bet some people wouldn't like that, because there are a good number of people that don't like tender driven locos. Yeah, I'll have to see. I'll have to see how many I've got. I don't know that I've got all that many. But good idea though. Right, let's see if Rutland's okay. Does she look like she's wheel slipping hugely? No, it doesn't look too bad. I think there's a bit of wheel slip going on there, but it doesn't look awful. Right, do you make a living from your channel, or do you have a job, says Joey? No, I do YouTube full-time now. So it is my job, which is obviously a massive privilege, and that's why I say I'm very, very grateful to everybody that, you know, that supports the channel and helps me to keep doing it, because it is what I love to do, believe it or not, playing with trains. And so that's why it means so much, you know, that I'm able to do it for a living. Right, Jason Bravo, he says, I believe Sam is ignoring my suggestions because they're too hard. In case Per Marquette with daylight of rolling stock of your choice. Well, no, I'm not ignoring it. If you want to submit a super chat for that, I could certainly do it. I will not ignore anybody. That is not my style. And thank you for the comment, I guess, too. Do Spencer pulling a good strain at top speed, says Charlie Sorliner. Oh, that's not a bad idea. I don't know whether Spencer would like that very much. Cowan. Okay. Cowan, says Toby Cowan. Okay, I'll try to remember that. Thank you for correcting me. Right, can you doublehead Thomas with the E2? Yes, I could certainly do that. EP3 says, do you have a girlfriend? Sadly not, I do live in Hope, although of course if any girls find out what I've got up here in the loft, I don't imagine they'd be interested for long, shall we put it that way? Right, let's bring these to a stop, shall we? Just before the, blimey, that's going faster, isn't it? The Duchess of Rutland train. I haven't sped that up, but it was going faster quite visibly there. But I think that's what happens sometimes with those Lima engines. They do tend to need a bit of warming up when they haven't been run for a while. Although I think Rodney was run, wasn't he? He was running a stream not long ago, either last time or maybe the time before that. But it wasn't long ago. It certainly wasn't. So perhaps old Rodney does need a bit of a service. I remember he was in a real mess when I first bought him. Yeah. Oh well, he worked. He warmed himself up in the end. It's not normally a problem if he's not double-heading. Of course, it just might have put the Duchess of Rutland under a bit of stress there, but I can't smell anything, and I didn't see any smoke, so I think we got away with that. But yeah, we'll have to see next time I give Rodney a bit of a service. We'll see how he goes with that. Okay, so let's move on then. We've done the requests. Okay, so Instagram. Yes, I've been bullied into it, basically. Everyone's been saying, can I follow you on Instagram? And I always said, well, no, because I haven't got an Instagram. So finally, I've decided to try it. I'm not much of an Instagram person. I do have a personal one, but I've hardly used it. So I thought I'd give it a try, and I've actually really enjoyed it, I must say. I've been posting mostly every day. I had a couple of days off this past couple of days. But yeah, I've been loving Instagram. It's a lot of fun. And if you want to follow me on there, it's Sam'sTrains Official, and there is a link in the description. But I also promised last week that I would be showing Instagram photos that you guys have been tagging me in. So I am going to do that. And I've been having quite a lot, so it will be a bit of a whistle-stop tour, but I will try to get... Listen to this. This is the phrase I regret. I'm going to try to get everybody in. So let's see if we can do this, shall we? So this is first on the Sam'sTrains Official hashtag. So let us begin. I hope you can still hear me, by the way. Please let me know if you can. So this is from Sterling Single Fan Number One. Look at that. It's not a Sterling Single, but a 14XX. So that's very, very lovely. Thank you for tagging me in that. Now, Togisaw, I know he's here. I've seen him in the chat. He says this is his old train layout. But the one thing I love about this is these diamond crossings. I mean, it's the most dangerous, ludicrous thing I think I've ever seen on a railway. But I absolutely love that. And that's very, very cool. And there's you name it. There's point work. There's a rise. A real challenge for his engines, that. So yeah, that's very, very cool. I enjoyed looking at that, and I'd love to see what his new layout looks like. Vlad Kopti, There we go. I love that. A lovely bit of perspective there with an engine. Looks like a Lima Prairie or something with a car in the foreground. Absolutely love that. So that's very nice. It looks like real trees in the background. So that's cleverly done. IM186, look at that. We have what looks like perhaps a Hudson, maybe, with an 08 in the foreground. Very nicely photographed. Eastleigh interchange, I guess. There it is. Looks very cool. Sorry, I sort of glazed over that. Let's not go over that, shall we? It's a ScotRail Class 158. There we go. Don't want to be glazing over anybody. Murray Dell. Blimey, I hope that wasn't mispronounced. So there we go. It looks like a Marklin, I would guess. Thank you very much for that one. That's very cool. Esperance 931. I guess I said that right. Anyway, look at that. Is that one of those Stania Moguls, or is it a crab? I don't know. Let me know. It's hard to tell, isn't it? 13174? I reckon that might be a Mogul. Well, it is a Mogul. It's a 260, it looks. So that's funny, isn't it? That's odd. Infinity Woomy says, did I miss anything? Well, you did a little bit, but you can go back if you want. So that's another one from the same person. 13174, yes, there we go. What a lovely collection of engines. I love that Class 47 in the background as well. That's great. Jason and Thomas, there we go. There's yours with the J50 there. Looks great. We have Dethrax Photo Wing. Oh, look at that, Bullet Pacific. Just love that. Lucas Massingham, there we go. Just the Great Western Toad there going into a tunnel, looks like. That's very nice. Trainspotter Southwest. Not sure what's happened there. It looks like a pannier tank's about to crash into a station platform. I'd love to know what happened next with that one. Sam'sTrains, oh, look at that. Peppercorn, looks like an A2. Oh, yeah, Trix A2, he says. Wow, that's quite impressive. No, never had a Trix model. That's pretty cool. Right, Paul Lawrence, there we go. Oh, look at that. Yes, I saw some of these pictures earlier on in the members only stream. But yes, very nice to see that. Where was this? At the Spring Gala, there we go. Forget where it was now. But yes, I saw lots of his pictures there. He's uploaded all sorts. So check out PLawrence32 if you want to see more. I can recommend them. Trainspotter Southwest, there we go. Awesome engine, that. It's the 121. In fact, that's the engine I forgot, isn't it, during the week? So, it's a 121. There you go. Another one from Paul. Oh, the Webb coal tank. Beautifully photographed, that one. And again, PLawrence. I will just skip across some of these, Paul. No offence. It's just... obviously, I want to get to as many people as I possibly can. And then the Sam'sTrains hashtag. We've got a lot of embarrassing pictures of me. Let's not look at those, if we can help it. So let's see, where do we start? Okay, I've seen some of these, but we'll have a look at this video. So this is from the Imperial Diamond Spinosaurus. What's it going to be? Guesses if there's time. Probably isn't. What's it going to be? Oh, it's the classic Flying Scotsman. Awesome. Very nice. Looks great. It's running good too. Oh, nice. It's got some teaks as well. Very nice. Thank you for that, Imperial Diamonds. Spinosaurus, we've seen that one. Don't know if we've seen that one. Perhaps not. George Trains. Oh, who was that? AJ Finley. Hi to you too. Thank you very much for that, AJ. I appreciate that. You're very, very kind. Right, so, as you can see, yes. I'm going to guess, Deltics. Oh, no, they're not. Hornby Railways Class 37s. If I'd read the description, I wouldn't have made such an idiot of myself. So Deco NZC, there we go. I don't recognise these, but they do look very, very awesome. So that's very cool. Nicely photographed as well, as always. That's another one, but we will skip over that right now. What's happening? Oh, that's another video. Esperance 931, that's another one. I think we've seen your stuff already, but that's another one. Imperial Diamond, we looked at you. Deco NZC again. Oh, that's a bit of a closer up. Oh, I didn't realise. Were the previous ones models then, or were they the real things? That's a really mess with me, that has. That was very good, though. We've seen that one. That was one of mine. That's Buddy, our hamster. Everybody was asking what its name was, but it is Buddy. There we go. He was a bit confused, bless him. I don't think he knew what was going on, but I think he enjoyed it overall. I've seen that one, seen that one, seen that one. We've seen Imperial Diamond. Oh, that one's mine, so we won't bother with that. Look at that one. Now, I've never seen this done before, a plane on a low loader. That is very, very cool. So that's a couple of those. Who were they? That was Graphic Design Studios. Very, very cool. That, we've seen that one. We haven't seen this one. Tallyton, 1864. Oh, whoa, blimey. That's the kind of video that makes you flinch, isn't it? Let's have that again, shall we? Whoa. That's very, very well shot. I can't believe how close you got the camera to that. Two Model Railway Viaducts, says Luke Michael 4778. Well, they're coming along really, really well. I love all the sort of lichen along the sides. That's looking great. You'll have to send us another picture once that's done. Taggart, Robert Taggart, he was one of the winners of the previous Bullmans. You see, I do send them. And obviously, they've done up the layout for Easter, so there's lots of Easter eggs there. That's very tempting, I would imagine, to break into the cabinet. But it's good to see that Bullman's still around and he's enjoying the Easter trains. That looks pretty cool. We've seen that one. We've seen that one because it was mine. We've seen that one. We've seen that one. I think some people have used the same hashtag twice, which is fine, of course. The train table, there we go. A large, well, is that large or small? I'm not sure. It's a prairie, I think, anyway. Tomomons, there you go. We've got a Thomas there. Wonder if that's the Marklin one, because they used something very similar to Hornby's, didn't they? This is interesting.
Got to do this carefully, because obviously these modern locos are quite fragile.
There we go, I think. Let's see.
Got to do this carefully.
Okay, yeah. Just a clip from my... I think these are old now. Yeah, we're getting old with these. These are from 2018. So we will stop there. I will say thank you very, very much to everybody who tagged me in Instagram. If you want to carry on tagging me, I will be going through and liking some of that stuff. So we will we'll get to a bit more of that later on. But let's have a look then. Shall we get on and do some more requests? I think it's time to, because we've got so many. So if you can bear it, I'm just going to go through and find who is owed a request. So what was the last one? So the last one was from Paul S. Was it? Because he asked for me to... Oh, no, that was from last week. I'm getting confused again. I don't know. Right, okay, so, yes. Okay, so it was Duckman. I will put just Duckman to save time. So he wants to see the N-Class on a mixed train. Yep, I can do that. I'll just put mixed. Danny Scott. Oh, I've already done that. Yeah, that's fine. Oh, Gareth Waite, there we go. You want to see Mallard with wagons. Now that is sacrilegious, if nothing else. But no, we'll do that. Mallard doesn't get a choice of what she pulls. Oh, Ginger, 15666, thank you so much. He says, for next time, Princess in either BR or LMS Maroon with a mix of Maroon and... just missed it. With a mix of Maroon and Pullman being banked by a pair of panniers in appropriate livery, please. Blimey, that sounds like an awful train. Not an awful train, an awfully big train, I should say. Didn't mean to call it awful, sorry. But yes, I could certainly do that. And thank you very much, Ginger, for the support. I really appreciate that. And of course, all of you guys are entered into Win Bullman or the Shunter's Truck, whichever one you're lucky enough to win. Okay, so yeah, we've got the Mallard with wagons. I don't know if Mallard's going to be happy, but well, it's been requested. So sorry, Mallard, you'll have to suck that one up, I think. Marcus McDonald. Ah, there we go. Marcus. So it's a standard 4, I'll just put 4, with a 9F. I'll put black, because he does want it black. And 8 green coaches. 8 green. Well, I've got a few on there already, so I'll have to get some more. And a parcels van. Yes, it's been a long while since I've got the parcels van out. Right, let's go and do this then. We will strip them all off the line if we can. I'll see which I can keep. Obviously, I want to keep the southern coaches, which is fine. We can do that. So let's get rid of the engines. I think we need one of the standards, don't we? Was it standard 4 or standard 5? Yes, it was standard 4. So which one's that? That's the one. Oh, cool. Well, that's handy, isn't it? So we can leave the 4 connected to the coaches, although I've derailed the tender already. So there we go. Standard 5, thank you for your service. I will put you to one side. You've probably had your moment for today. So we might as well finish that one, haven't we? And then that's one sorted. So we want the 9F, preferably in black. So that is going to be interesting because my... Oh, that is going to be interesting because this is DCC fitted, which means it runs very, very fast on DC. I'm just wondering whether this is a good idea, but I think it is. We'll try it. And as we've just seen, the Backman standards run very, very slowly. So I think we're going to end up with a bit of a tug of war on this. So this one might just be a one lap job, I reckon. But let's see. I dread to see. But oh, it's not too bad. I wonder if this is draining some of the current from it then, because normally that just flies along that 9F. Okay, well, that's problem solved. That's not too bad. So how many more coaches do we need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think he said 8, so I'll make that 3 more coaches. We can steal the Shunter's truck. Being very careful, I don't want to ruin that. So I need to get 3 more coaches. Obviously, this shouldn't be a problem to pull because they're such strong engines, and putting them together
is a very, very strong combination. So there we go, three more coaches, and I've got to find one of the vans. Let's have a look. I think I know what he means. Well, I'll put on what I think he means, and if it's wrong, he can berate me for it. I give him permission. It's a Ren one. Yeah, I'm not sure whether this is a baggage car or a parcels van, but I'm sure someone will be able to let me know. That's it. Can you see that? Don't run it very often, which is a shame because it's very nice. So that's that anyway. Okay, so I'll put that on first. And we'll shove the other coaches in. So these are slightly darker green coaches, but I suppose that's all right, because sometimes the coaches didn't always match in real life, so I don't mind a bit of that. Or when I've managed to put a brake halfway through the train. But again, apparently that sort of happened in real life as well, so that's all right. Okay, so we'll take off the disgraced pannier train. By the way, this pannier tank literally got service yesterday, so that's timing for you, isn't it? I mean, it's only been about a year since she was last done, so it's not as though she was in dreadful disrepair or anything like that, but, you know, at least she's been done nice and fresh. So, let's have a look then. So, the middle line, what are we going to put on there? So, we want, oh yes, Mallard with some wagons. Come on then, Mallard, you're not going to like this, but there's not a lot we could do. Where are you? She's hiding, I can't see her. Oh, yes I can. Can't hide from me, Mallard. I'm sorry, I know. It's happening though, it's happening. Okay, she's protesting, can you tell? Right, we won't go with too many. I tell you what, just to save a bit of time, we'll put on some that's already been on. So, there you go, Mallard. You got some Great Western ones as well. Blimey, this is not going to go well for Mallard. So not only is she hauling wagons, but she's hauling them from other railways too. Oof. Now that is nasty. Sorry, Mallard. Oops. Now, if this all derails, I suppose that's karma, isn't it? Probably will deserve it. All right, so some of the beverage vans are coming back out, and tanks and whatever. But it's all considered goods, isn't it? So we can do that. Okay, and a brake. Can't have a good train without a brake. Here we go. It's not an LNER one, but I think we're throwing that out of the window with this, aren't we? And then Duckman wanted to see an N-Class with a mixed, well, what did he say? Did he say mixed train or mixed freight? Because they do mean different things, don't they? Well, I'll tell you what, we'll do a true mixture and we'll mix freight and passenger stuff together. Because that suits. So, let us take this away. Now, the N-Class is quite a temperamental engine. That's one thing I didn't tell you, Mark. They're a nightmare and a half to service, but I'm sure you'll find that out on your own. But when they are serviced, they do run very nicely. Okay, so the N-Class, here's mine. I wonder if we've got the same one, Mark. It's number 1824 in very, very tiny lettering. There it is. We'll put it on that way, shall we? All right, and I've got to find the tender. Oop, nope, it's not on right. There we go. Heavy, isn't it? Blimey, I'd forgotten how heavy that was. Right, I'm just going to have to search for the tender. Tender. This is the problem, you know. So many tenders looking down on them from above, you can never find the one you want. And then what I tend to do is I start on the top drawer and decide that it's not in the top drawer. And then I go down to the next drawer down and then the next one and the next one. And I get to the bottom and I think, oh, well, it's not there at all. And then I go back to the top drawer and I see it straight away. And I think that's probably what's just about to happen. No, I'm back at the top drawer, and I can't see it here either. Oh, I can. Literally, exactly what I've just said has come true. Okay. And that's another thing, the coupling between the loco and tender was a nightmare on my original one, so I've just got a bit of sort of scrap plastic sticking out there, which has got a hole in it. And the tender sort of sits onto that hole. And it's very crude, and it's not very good, but I can tell you it's better than what was on there to start with from Backman. So that's that. Right, so we want some passenger and some goods, so I'll put some box vans out, I think, for it. Let's say four of those, and then just to make it extra specially odd, we'll mix those in with some Pullmans, I think. So there we go, got some of those vans. Put those on first. There we are. Four of those, and then what do you reckon, three Pullmans? Yeah, that should be all right, shouldn't it? It's not a massive engine, this, so I don't want to put far too much on, but yes. So, Duckman, Ugly Duckman, and Mark, this is for you, the N-Class fans. And it has been ages, hasn't it, since I've shown an N-Class. So, yep, looking forward to seeing this one run, if it still will. Although, I think I had to go forwards a touch then, didn't I? So, yep, she is still working, as you can see. So, there you go then, Mallard, on your walk of shame with the good train. And then the big 9F/Standard Class 4 train. So, let's have a quick run with these then. Watch these running. All right, there you go, that's the best view. There we go, look at that. Most of the shots have got something going on in them. Very nice. Look at that N-Class, wow. It looks great really, doesn't it? No matter what ridiculous train you put behind it, it does look great. Let's have a look then. Let's wait for it to come out from behind the bookcase. Oh, that didn't sound very good. Let's watch, folks. I think there might be a derailment. I can't tell, but it sounds like one. Maybe I'm just super paranoid. Oh, yeah. Oh, gosh. Yeah, it's the 9F's tender. I tell you what, there's a story with the 9F's tender. Basically, the thing collapsed. The tender completely collapsed on the inside. I think something else is off as well. Ugh, that N-Class tender's off as well. Anyway, yeah, the 9F tender. Basically, because Hornby, I won't say don't know what they're doing, but basically because Hornby don't know what they're doing, they used a certain type of material, a certain type of Mazak, which basically decays over time and falls to pieces. And that happened with my tender, unfortunately, on the 9F. And it just completely disintegrated. So what I did was I just took the axles and the bearings and glued the bearings in place and hoped for the best. And it does seem to work, although it does seem to be under a bit of pressure at the moment, having been put into a double header. And you can see something unpleasant has happened over here. I think we're doomed, aren't we, with this one. But we'll try it, we'll try it. As I say, the 9F's DCC fitted, so it's trying to go really fast. And the standard class 4 doesn't want to. And basically, it's a bit of an argument. But we'll go with one more lap, see if we can't fix things. Oh, and thank you, whoever that was. I will come back and have another look. Yes, let's have a look. So yeah, the 9F. Not very impressed with that from Hornby, but luckily they seem to have sorted the Mazak issue out. Right, is that better? Oh, I see what happened. The 9F cut out on the point work. And the standard class 4 sort of rammed into it from behind. Yeah, interesting. Okay. Well, we'll try it one more time. And if it all derails on the second lap, we'll give it in for a bad job, shall we? Yep. Whoa. This isn't good, folks. We've got a runaway. See what I mean about it wanting to go fast? Right. Oh my gosh. Okay, this is a disaster, folks. Got it. There we go. Crikey. Well, that was frightening. Thank you for whoever thought of that idea. I don't know if I don't imagine it was engineered to be frightening, but it certainly was. And we've got this standard 4 seems to be stranded. Yep, it is stranded. Right. I'll try and rescue it, shall I? Just amuse yourselves for a second, folks. Blimey, I'm not used to so much excitement. I think the trouble is it's too big a train to manage on its own, the standard class 4. It really needed that 9F helping. Right, well, we'll stop Mallard. After all that, it's only Mallard that's behaving. I can hear the N-Class tender come off again. So we seem to have gotten a round of requests where all of the tenders misbehave. Somehow or other. Although, if I can hear properly, I think the N-Class tender has gone back onto the track properly, so maybe we'll be okay with that. We'll have to see if it arrives. Right. My word, that was a disaster, wasn't it? Crikey. I think that'll have to go down as the worst disaster ever on a live stream. But normally that would be a bad thing, you know, if I was trying to film a video. But since it's live, it's all good fun, isn't it? So yes, a cock-up. Very, very nice. I hope people enjoyed. Let's have a look at the chat and people and see what people have got to say about that. Right, what was the super chat I missed? Okay, it was sideways. Just the wrong timing there, just as the disaster was unfolding. So he says, hey Sam, how are you? Could you run Percy pulling an ocean of ocean wagons? Got a couple of requests for this ocean of ocean wagons. And a Queen Mary brake van. If not, then an LMS brake van. You need one. I do have one. Right, well, let's do another round then, shall we? It sounds like we're in a pub. Let's do another round. Let's write down the next lot of requests then, shall we? Right, so let's have a look. So that was Marcus McDonald, wasn't it? That was the last one. So let's have a look. So Jake, darling. All right, darling, nice to hear from you again. So it was a Britannia. I've only got trying Britannias, but I hope that's all right for you, with a class 47. So I can do that. Yep, no problem. Let's have a look. Can you do a double header with a Black 5? So this was Train Dude, which is a very cool name, 456. So that's Black 5 plus Henry. Yep, I can do that. That's no problem. And let's just refresh and get one more. And then I think after that one more, we will save the rest until next week. But that's absolutely fine. If you don't mind holding on, that's very, very good of you. Ginger, you did say for next time, but I'm going to get this one in for you. So we want to see. Oh, this is scary. Okay, so it's a Princess with, well, it says either LMS or BR maroon, but we'll go just put maroon and see what I've got, with a mix of maroon, I guess he means maroon coaches, with Pullmans, and a pair of panniers. Well, I'll try. I'll sure try. I'm frightened to death of that idea because of all the derailments we've just had, but normally it's the unexpected that happens on this railway, so knowing my luck, it'll probably just be absolutely fine. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll try to recycle some of these coaches. So we'll take the back lot off because I don't want too many coaches if I can help it, because as you can see, you get massive derailments and things. It shouldn't be a problem, but normally, you know, when I'm filming videos and things, I can set it all up to make sure all the couplings are, you know, properly together. And I can, sometimes I'll think, oh, actually, this piece of rolling stock doesn't go so well with this loco and that sort of thing. In the streams, it's a lot more haphazard than that. Obviously, you can't think these things through, otherwise you'd be at it all day. But thank you very much, whoever that was. I'll come over and have a look. For the most part, it seems to work all right, doesn't it? I don't tend to get too many massive issues, but yeah, there are some. Right, it was Nirate, I think. I think I saw him there. Oh, it was. I know you won't like this, but the Tango with the mega boxes and your fancy light-up brake van, please, says Nirate Girl. Well, thank you very much for that. It will have to be next episode now, but either way, thank you for that, and yes, I will get around to that at some point. So yes, thank you once again. Right, let's have a look. So I'm going to put the Britannia and the Class 47 on this tray, so that should be okay. Okay, so Train Dude 456 wants to see the Black 5 and Henry, so that can go on this train. That should be absolutely fine. Double heading, of course. And then the other one was the Princess with, so this can be the start of the Princess train, although we do want some maroon coaches mixed in with that too, so we'll do that. Don't think he wants the box fans on the end though, so we'll take those away. There we go. Get rid of those. Right, so this is the one that frightens me, folks. So I think we'll try and keep this down a little bit. So we'll go with, let's say, just two maroon coaches. Okay, I got those. A pair of panniers. Well, I think we'll go with two panniers that are the same then. We'll go with the triangle ones because, oh, hang on. This might be an issue. I think we might make this a triangle train then, folks, because my only maroon Princess made by Hornby is DCC fitted. And I don't fancy causing that calamity again by putting a DCC fitted and a DC loco together where one's pulling the other one. So we'll go with all triangle, and that's all right because I've got a couple of triangle panniers, so that'll be okay. Now, obviously, the only issue with triple heading is that it gets a little bit heavy, shall we say, on the old controllers. These controllers are, what's this one rated for? So this one's only rated for 550 milliamps. And anybody that knows electric torque is going to be laughing at that, because I've noticed this one's not got a front coupling, so we'll have to grab the one from earlier. Because these locos tend to pull about, what? A good modern loco pulls about perhaps 200 milliamps. So you probably get three modern locos and the controller's going to be warm. But the trying locos obviously pull quite a bit more current. They can pull up to perhaps 300 milliamps a piece, which is a bit more dodgy. I think it will be okay for a short period of time, but if the controller blows up, we'll know that it wasn't okay. So I'm just looking for the right princess tender right now, and I've found it. So we'll have to see if this works. I mean, in reality, the controllers don't tend to blow up. Obviously, they just, the voltage drops and the engines slow down, and probably they'll just cut out. But we will see, we will see. It should be all right, I think. I think, we'll see. Okay. So yeah, one of the green panniers that I pulled out unfortunately doesn't have a front coupling, so we've had to scrap that, but luckily the other one's got a trying motor in it as well, so should be all right. Right, let's see if it all works, shall we? It's been a long while since I've run some trying stuff on this channel. It's been almost too long, really. All right, okay, well, that sort of seems to be working, so that's all right. Oh no, I've just realized my Black 5 is DCC fitted as well, and my Henry isn't. But there's not much I can do about that, because I've only got that other Black 5. So, Henry, good luck, old friend. You're definitely, definitely going to need it. This is going to be, well, let's not frighten him, shall we? Shall we just say it's going to be fine? Yeah, I think, Henry, I think this is going to be fine. Ugh, can't get his front bogey on, though. There we go. Oh, man. Oh, and his tender's off. Oh, goodness. Make sure his wheels are all right, because the Hornby Henry, for some reason, is notorious for the tender wheels falling to pieces, isn't it? I don't know why. This stream's not a very good advocate for Hornby, is it? But it's all true. You will find the same thing. The number of emails I've had about the Hornby Henry and the tenders falling apart, you would not believe it. But of course I had to believe it, because the same thing happened to mine, so I knew exactly what people were telling me. Right, man, this is going to be interesting. The one thing is, this Black 5 isn't all that powerful though, because it's got such a heavy tender, so even if it is pulling itself along, it shouldn't be too bad. All right, oh yes, it's certainly going for it, that Black 5. Henry, you're going to have to try and keep it under control. Okay, so I need to get the trying Britannia, I forgot about that. Right, let's have a look then. So, we'll go with Britannia. There she is, and we want a class 47, was it? Let me just double check, because if I get it wrong, that's not going to be good. I think it was. Yeah, it was a 47, so I'll dig out a 47. It's going to look odd, because my 47 is a virgin one, I think. I mean, it has been run. It's a virgin livery, that's what I mean. Or I could go with the Lima one, because the virgin one looks like it's buried underneath a load of coaches, so I think we'll do that. But first of all, I'm just trying to find my Britannia tender, and I'm just looking for that now. I think I found it. This might be Owen Glendower's tender, because it's glossy, but I think it will do. Okay, and I'll just search through my old diesel drawers now. Ah, yes, I've got a 47. Right, Henry and the Black 5 have almost completed one lap. I'm not 100% sure whether anything has derailed, but we'll have to see. Sounds all right. Yeah. I wonder if we got away with that then. I think we probably did. Not bad. Okay, so my Britannia has got the realistic, in fact, chuffing sound, as seen on James May's TV programmes and things. I don't know if you'll hear that, but I'll try and get close enough so that you can. Right, let's start that up then. We've got them all going in the same direction this time. Right, let me try and get the microphone close to the Britannia. You'll be able to hear it, but you might not see. Yeah, it's a very, very faint chuffing coming from that, so maybe you didn't hear it, I don't know. It's just passing on the bottom left. There you go. Hello.
Right, let's have a look, see what people are saying in the old chat. Dude, lol. Not Henry. What's happened to Henry? People are saying about Henry. I don't know where he's got to. There's the princess. No, I think Henry seems all right. I can just about see him. The princess train is going quite slowly, though, which is a bit concerning. As I say, the controller is considerably overloaded with that, which is probably not a good idea, but the engines seem all right, don't they? More or less, more or less. It's a nice idea, though. I love the idea of having two panniers banking. Well, that looks cool. It looks like Henry and the Black Five, after all, do get on with each other quite well, so that's all right. In fact, do you know what? I wonder if my Black Five isn't DCC fitted anymore. I think I took the chip out so that I could do that, the competition between Henry and the Black Five. I think I de-chipped it ready for that. So if I did, that explains, doesn't it? That explains a lot. There's the Triang train. I think what we'll do is we'll stop it after this lap. Because, as I say, I don't want my controller to blow up or burn out. I'd love to know how much current it's pulling. I bet there's got to be 700 milliamps there. But the thing is, my other HM2000s are rated for over an amp, or it might be 800 milliamps. But I've measured over an amp coming out of them before. So I'm not worried, but it shouldn't be done unattended. You should be watching. It doesn't feel too warm. There we are. I did have the speed set quite low, actually, as well, admittedly, so that will have been part of the reason. Right, we're just waiting for Henry then and the Black Five. Rattling along. Henry's tender does rattle, I've noticed that. Alright, there we go. Well, that was quite successful, wasn't it? So thank you to everybody, thank you to Jake Darling, TrainDude456 and Ginger for those. I do appreciate the super chats, of course, and very, very awesome requests too. So with that, folks, I think that is basically it for today. I don't have any more to show you, really. Thank you for everybody that has donated today. Massive, massive generosity. Oops, I've just dropped my pen. I will go through and thank everybody that has donated, and of course everybody I read out is entered for the various competitions and things, and it's not going to be long, Brisket, until you get your new home. Alright, just waiting on the refresh, there we go. So let's take a quick look at everybody from today. Here we go, you ready? This is the list. So we have Jack Clark, AZ Rail, Milo McQuillan, Deltic Dan 900. Nice to hear from you, Deltic Dan, again. William Town, Paul S, Javon A Bird, The Ugly Duckman, James Stewart, Danny Scott, SuperDude24, Gareth Waite, Charles Curtis, Marcus McDonald, William Town, Jake Darling, Colin Wykes, William Town again, Steam Traction Spotter, TrainDude456, AG Finley Jr., Ginger 115666, Nirate Goal, Sideways, and quite a few more. From Nirate, and I will get onto yours next time, Nirate. Now, one announcement. Next Sunday stream is going to have to be moved to Monday because, as you know, it's Mother's Day here in the UK on next Sunday, so there's no way I can do a stream like that on Mother's Day. And so what I've decided to do is move the stream onto the following day, so it's going to be on Monday night, the 1st of April, I think it is. So it's going to be the same time, just the following day. So you're going to be needing to tune in on Monday rather than Sunday. And I won't say anything about it at all. Just make sure you tune in because I think you'll quite enjoy it. Let's just say that. All right, folks. Well, thank you all very, very much for running. Sorry, for running. I don't know. If you've been running, well, thank you for doing that. But if you've been watching, which is probably more likely, then thank you very much. Andrew Keeley, nice to see you. He says, good run. Well, it was an all right run. I did have a bit of a disaster. I don't know if you saw it. But scroll back if you want to see me run across the room to stop a runaway 9F. Man, that was frightening. It literally bolted right the way around the room and nearly smacked into the back of the train. Managed to catch it at the last minute, though. Either way, thank you very much to everybody who's been in the chat. It's been a great chat today. Lots of jokes, by the way. Terrible jokes at the start, but I enjoyed them nonetheless. Thank you all very, very much for joining. There's everybody here. Dab and Clickbait says top class live. No, I think I'm going to do something more serious this year. The April Fool's thing exhausted me a bit last year. So maybe not. But either way, Luke Thomas says bye, Sam. Bye, Michael Forster. Class 9, 0002. I wasn't noticed. Oh, okay, I don't know what you mean. Okay, oh well. See you next time, Adam Rushton. I'll be at work, Jake Darling. Don't worry, Jake. It's always available afterwards to watch. Not a problem. That was the best part, says Andrew Keeley. Oh, I guess he was watching then. All right, folks. Well, thank you all very much for watching. Thanks again for your support, as always. And I will see you all very, very soon. In fact, there are some videos coming out in the week. Two reviews this time, one of them American and one of them not. So there you go. That's your little clue. Until then, I will see you on Monday. Don't forget, Monday night at 5 o'clock. And I hope you have a good week. All right. Cheers then, folks. I will see you all very soon. Take care of yourselves. And once again, thank you for watching and thank you for all the support.
Hey folks, thank you very much for tuning into today's stream. I really hope you enjoyed that one. I'll be back next Sunday for another episode of Sam'sTrains Live at 5 o'clock, so please feel free to join me there if you want to. For now though, folks, have a great week. I'll see you throughout the week with some more videos, and you all take care of yourselves. Cheers, everybody.